two prosecution witnesses in the remaining drug case, so former Philippine Senator Laila Dirima, are said to be willing to recant their testimonies. Rodolfo Magleo and Nonilo Arile reportedly expressed their intention in a letter to Dirima. Magleo and Arile had previously accused her of receiving drug money to found this former senator's senatorial campaign. Dirima's lawyer, Dino De Leon, says the two men admitted their statements against Dirima have bothered their conscience. They also claim five other witnesses will recant their statements against the former senator. Dirima has been jailed since 2016 on drug charges, two of which have already been dismissed. And we'll be speaking now to the legal counsel and spokesperson of former Senator Laila Dirima, Attorney Dino De Leon. Attorney De Leon, welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us today.
Good afternoon, Carmina, and to all our viewers.
Right. First of all, we're going to talk about the letter in a bit, but first of all, did you get any sense that this recantation, possible recantation, because we haven't seen it yet, right? All they did was give that letter of stating their intention to the former senator. So did you get any sense that this recantation, possible recantation, was forthcoming?
No, we did not. We were very much surprised when it happened. In fact, what happened was Rodolfo Magleo was supposed to testify yesterday before the court. He is a prosecution witness, and the prosecution was about to present him during that day. But in the morning, we were not yet present in court, right? He walks to Senator Laila Dirima and handed him her a letter. And the letter states that they are recanting. So our second point would be that there is an actual recantation, and they explicitly stated that they were bothered by their conscience. Of course, there will be a legal process to vet them, possibly presenting them before the witness stand. But for us, we were quite shocked at that particular point in time because we didn't know what to do, but we had the duty to be candid to the court as officers of the court. So when Magleo was presented by the prosecution, and he was already under oath at that particular point in time, we stated that there was a letter received by Senator Laila Dirima. The prosecution was also shocked. They didn't know that it was going to happen. We approached the bench. We showed the letter to the presiding judge. And then he explicitly asked if the prosecution knew that that was going to happen. And they said no. So they were also shocked as we were. And then thereafter, the presiding judge asked Magleo, after he was placed under oath in the witness stand, if it was his signature and if he's confirming the letter and the contents therein, which explicitly states that they were bothered by their conscience and they are recanting all the testimonies they had against Senator Laila Dirima, and he confirmed the authenticity of his signature and that is the letter.
So it wasn't as if this letter just came out of nowhere. It was handed to the former senator, although it was dated October 12th, if I'm not mistaken. It was handed to the senator. It was presented to the judge. The judge then verified the authenticity of this letter. And because of that whole process, there is no doubt anymore about the authenticity of the letter written by Rodolfo Magleo.
There's none, and in fact, it was done in front of the prosecution. And the judge, in fact, made sure that Magleo will not be returned anymore to the Sablayan Penal Colony because Magleo said that his life is in danger. So that this is contained in the order of the Honorable Judge. So that was verified by the Honorable Judge himself and by the court. And you know, our stand is Magleo said under oath that it was his signature and that he did that. So the recantation was already there. And in fact, the prosecution had the chance to do their cross-examination, but they chose to no longer present Magleo as their witness because they say, and I quote, it appears that he became all of a sudden hostile
witness.
Right. So that's why they withdrew him as a witness. But he already confirmed under oath that was his letter, and he is already recanting his testimony. And the prosecution could have asked him questions at that point in time, but they chose not to do so. They withdrew him as a witness instead.
What's going to happen to Nonilo Arile?
Nonilo Arile, per the order of the Honorable Court, the Honorable Court asked the BU Corps officials to make sure that he is safe and that he will be transferred as well in Muntinlupa.
Here's the thing, in that letter, it wasn't just Nonilo Arile, it wasn't just Rodolfo Magleo. That letter also claims that there are others that are going to follow suit.
Five more, according to the letter. No, it is consistent, Carmina, with our stand that all of these witnesses who are under the custody of the state, they can push the right buttons to make sure that they will have a hard time saying no to whatever demands the state would have. All of these witnesses are manufactured during the time of President Duterte. That has always been the defense of the defense of Senator Laila de Lima, and that this is a politically motivated case. So it's a frame up, and the frame up is of course showing itself little by little. A total of 6 witnesses already, to be clear. It was Kerwin Espinosa said that he was threatened, he was coerced, his life was in danger and that of his family. That was also the testimony of Roddy the Dayan when he recanted his testimony, his allegations and accusations against Senator Laila de Lima. We saw that being done by Rafael Adorco in Kerwin Espinosa's case, and we saw Rafael Ragos even apologizing to Laila de Lima and saying that he was bothered by his conscience and he did it only because he was threatened by the Duterte administration, and specifically named DOJ Secretary Aguirre during that time. Now we have Nonilo Arile and Rodolfo Magleo. So these are 6 witnesses used by the prosecution and by the state in various cases and various avenues in the persecution of Laila de Lima. And we expect and we call on other witnesses to do the right thing, because we all know for a fact that Senator Laila de Lima is innocent, and these are all fabricated charges and are lies.
Possible 6 more witnesses to recant their statements against the former senator. How crucial is this development in this last remaining drug case against the former senator, Attorney De Leon?
You know, right from the very start, based on our evaluation, there is no single credible iota of proof against Laila de Lima. Whether they recant or not, by face value of their testimonies anyway, all of their testimonies are, we heard it. We heard it from another inmate that the funds will be used for Senator Laila de Lima's campaign, right? There is no single gram of drugs that was offered in evidence, despite the fact that this is a drug trading case. No flow of money. So you can't be certain how the trade exactly happened. What we only have are incredible witnesses who are mostly convicted felons who are now recanting their testimonies. And the other credible witnesses, like for example General Magalong, categorically stated that there is no evidence whatsoever or no investigation whatsoever linking Laila de Lima to drugs or to any impropriety whatsoever. That was also the testimony of the AMLAC of, officials and investigators, saying that they have no investigation whatsoever linking Laila de Lima to any illegal flow of money in her bank account. So the credible witnesses clearly say that Laila de Lima is innocent. What we have are incredible witnesses who are convicted felons, who are not qualified to begin with, and whose credibility are in question. They're not qualified to become state witnesses, and who are now recanting. Mm-hmm. So hopefully all of these things will be will of course be appreciated by the Honorable Court when we do our submissions.
Attorney De Leon, talk to us about that moment when that letter was handed to the former senator, and as she began to read every single word written on that letter, what was that moment like? What did she tell you? How did she react to that letter?
You know, she was so nervous. No, I was so nervous at that point in time. We didn't know if it was a trap. We didn't know if we offer it, then he will say all of a sudden, no, what are these people talking about? But Senator Laila de Lima, after being in, jailed for close to 7 years now, or 7 years now, she was so nervous. And you know, it was a tense situation for all of us counsels who were present and who were with Laila de Lima. But ultimately, when we said, you know, we have to follow our oath as lawyers, and we have to be come clean towards the court. We owe the court the complete candor about the situation. So ultimately, of course, we decided to present the letter to the Honorable Court, and you know, just face the consequences, because truth is on our side anyway. If all of a sudden he will disclaim that he handed the letter, so be it. But the truth is on our side. But we were so nervous. I saw Senator Laila de Lima, of course, a little bit tense, and afterwards, after all the adrenaline was gone, we were sitting there and you know, naubusan kami ng lakas. But we were happy. We were happy that at least everything turned out pretty well. When you tell the truth, hopefully everything will always turn out to be well. And the witness himself, Rodolfo Magleo, confirmed the authenticity of the letter.
Let me just go back to what you said a while ago. You said in so many words, whether there were witnesses who recanted or not, you believe that there was no credible proof that was really offered against Senator Laila de Lima. But give it to us straight. You needed this letter.
Well, we hope that there will be developments like this, just so that, you know, the truth will come out. As to whether we needed it, I don't believe so. But as to whether it's a positive development when it comes to seeking out the truth and nothing but the truth, then we believe that it's a good development for the case.
When you read the letter, though, and correct me if I'm wrong, they wanted to come out and tell the truth in 2018. It's already 2023, Attorney De Leon. And what did the letter state about why they didn't come out then, back in 2018?
You know, it's a perfect answer to questions like, why are just they recanting now? It is explicit in the letter that they wanted to recant as early as 2018 because they were bothered by their conscience. That is explicit in the letter. And it is also explicit in the letter stating that it was impossible for them to do so because they cannot communicate to the public. They are convicted felons. They cannot just go to the media, ask the media, or do, you know, recantations easily. Let's remember that they are under the custody of the state. And supposedly, the highest officers of the state are the architects of this frame-up, Rodrigo Duterte himself, right? These are all contained in the even the reports of the Working Group on Arbitrary Detention as to why it categorically found that this is a political persecution. So, of course, it wasn't easy for them. Their lives were in danger, were at stake, and that of their families. So it was impossible for them logistically, too, as stated in the letter. And this was the only time that they had the opportunity to hand over the letter to Laila de Lima. That particular event was also it was also a bit impossible, right? Because they were also constrained. It was a good, it was at least good that they were able to do that. Mm-hmm. It was an opportunity that they found, and we are glad that it happened because the truth is finally starting to come out.
But stranger things have happened, Attorney De Leon, as you know. So where do you go from here?
You know, it was like watching a movie, even the courtroom yesterday. The prosecution witness recanting and stating that, you know, he was forced, coerced, and his life is in danger. I've seen so many strange things in these cases that, you know, you don't see in law school and in my almost 10 years in practice. We will continue to fight for vindication, for the truth, because ultimately, Senator Laila de Lima is innocent, and she will consistently uphold the truth, and will consistently fight for her vindication. So the only way forward is to carry on with the fight, because Senator Laila de Lima never wavered in her belief that the fight is worth it, and that she is innocent, and that's why we will continue to fight.
As a final question, Attorney De Leon, is one thing to fight for vindication. It's another thing to hold those responsible accountable. What is your legal advice to the former senator? After all this is said and done, are you going to advise her to just walk away, or are you advising her to hold those responsible for her incarceration to account?
Senator Laila de Lima is a bar-top notcher, used to be the chairperson of the Commission on Human Rights, and one of the fiercest, if not the fiercest, Secretary of Justice that we've had. She always fights for the right thing, the truth, which is why she's incarcerated. She doesn't really need my advice with respect to that particular point, because she herself stated when she was interviewed there will be a day of reckoning, Mr. President. That was her statement when she was asked what would be her message to President Duterte and her persecutors. There will be a day of reckoning. And you know, considering the character of Senator Laila de Lima, she will always fight for the right thing and the truth and the rule of law. And she will hold these people who fabricated charges against her and her persecutors into account.
Mm-hmm. By the way, before we let you go, that motion for reconsideration with regard to the bail, how's that coming along? What's the latest on that?
We actually reminded the court that there was a pending incident, and the court acknowledged it. So that is pending resolution, and we are hoping for the best.
All right. Attorney Dino De Leon, their legal counsel and spokesperson for former Senator Laila de Lima. Thanks for joining us today. Take care.
Thank you very much, Carmina, and good afternoon again.